today's numbers that matter, 1,173. The Philippine Justice Department says it will tap that number of prosecutors to address cybersecurity concerns in the country. The agency is also deploying hundreds of prosecution attorneys to help curb the same problem. Now, this move from the DOJ came after the National Police reported cybercrime cases in Metro Manila rose by 152% in the first half of the year.
The Philippines agreeing to improve ties with two African countries. The Philippines and Malawi will further enhance cooperation in agriculture, especially on enhancing rice production, as well as student exchanges. This was agreed upon when Malawi Ambassador Kwacha Chisiza presented his credentials to President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Thursday. And also meeting the president in Malacanang, Namibia's Ambassador Herman Pule Diamonds. The two countries will explore more comprehensive bilateral ties, especially on trade and industry and agriculture.
A Philippine government panel pushes for the extension of lower tariffs on key commodities. More on that from Lady Vicencio, now joins us on the line. Lady, go ahead.
Yes, Stanley, the Interagency Committee on Inflation and Market Outlook has recommended the extension of Executive Order No. 10 imposing lower tariff for rice, corn, and pork imports. The National Economic and Development Authority Secretary Arsenio Balisacan said that the proposal is to extend the EO's effectivity until December 31, 2024 to prevent further local price increases. Balisacan said that the recommendation will have to go through consultation and assessment by the Tariff Commission but must be decided on by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. before the executive order expires on December 31, 2023. Meanwhile, the NEDA stressed that the government is working on interventions to control inflation as inflation target of 2 to 4% is now quite a challenge. Balisacan said that while average inflation may hit out of bounds of the target, the 4% inflation target by year end is still achievable. Even with rising inflation, Balisacan said Filipinos should have a better Christmas this year compared to the last 3 years with higher employment rates. The economic chief also expects holiday spending to boost GDP to attain at least the 6% growth target. Balisacan gave no confirmation if the DBCC will adjust its targets, but he noted that the higher end of the growth target may be hard to reach at this point. He also expressed his opposition to another interest rate hike and said that there is no urgency to hike with core inflation at a decline at this point. Stanley?
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Lady Vicencio.
Photography and printing company Canon bullish about the Philippine market. Canon Marketing Philippines President and CEO Anuj Agrawal told ANC the company expects to grow in the country as the local economy also prospers. He adds Canon is on track to hit pre-pandemic levels by year end.
We are very bullish about Philippines. Mm-hmm. So we expect the market to grow in Philippines, where people's spending power will go up, mm-hmm. and they will we will see the lower middle class shifting to the middle class. Now what we are trying to do is, first is trying to get back to normal. So that's why we have given a slogan, BTN 2019. So we believe 2019 was the normal year. After that, we have a disruptive period. So first is to back to normal 2019. First, go back to 2019 level and then start growing, take off.
E-wallet giant GCash ramping up offerings to the unbanked population. The firm announced Friday the launch of a new payment card in a partnership with credit card corporation Visa. Users of the GCash card will receive benefits enjoyed by bank account holders, including quick ATM withdrawals. The new card can also be used as an alternative payment option at over 100 million merchants around the world. GCash says any fully verified user can order the card through its app without additional documents or approvals. The Philippine Transportation Department is coordinating with the Asian Development Bank to fund more transport infrastructure projects. Transport Secretary Jaime Bautista says his agency will continue to tap the ADB to open opportunities for equitable progress and growth for business investment, tourism, and employment. Data show there are 9 infrastructure funding agreements between the DOTR and the ADB for aviation, railways, and road projects worth 1.2 trillion pesos. Apart from funding, the DOTR is also seeking the multilateral lender's technical assistance in terms of developing a right-of-way acquisition manual for projects and other frameworks.
Billionaire Elon Musk is sued by the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission to compel him to testify as part of a probe into his $44 billion takeover of Twitter. The U.S. regulator says it subpoenaed Musk in May, requiring him to provide testimony, and Musk agreed to appear on September 15. But then, 2 days before, Musk told the SEC he would not appear, raising several objections. The world's richest man had accused the SEC of harassing him, but the commission said it is only trying to obtain information from Musk relevant to its investigation. The SEC is looking into whether Musk broke several securities laws in 2022 when he took over the social media giant, which he renamed X. Global trade growth taking a hit this year. The World Trade Organization says high inflation and interest rates, as well as the war in Ukraine and strains on China's property market, are putting pressure on economies. The WTO has cut its trade growth forecast to just 0.8% this year, less than half its previous projection of 1.7% back in April. The trade outlook for next year is more favorable, with a projection of 3.3% growth.